Hello, my name is Sergei Izmailov. I'm going to present to you our approach to introducing disulfide bond formation mechanism into molecular dynamics. I will tell you why this method is important, what are known approaches to that problem. I'll briefly discuss the physics of disulfide bond formation and our model with its assumptions and limits. We studied our algorithm on two targets. It's peptide, short peptide guanylin and protein proguanylin. Let's move on. The mechanism of disulfide bond formation is important because it's an important part of protein folding. Nowadays, molecular dynamic simulations is able to fold relatively small globular proteins, but not proteins with disulfide bonds. So our method will extend molecular dynamics simulations for those class of proteins. So it's really nice to have such method. What was done before us is the two methods. First is the calculus, so-called calculus method. It introduced artificial spring between two sulfur items. Step by step, pull two sulfur atoms together, and finally makes a bond. Downsides of this method: it needs extra information in advance about which residues you want to pull to each other, and this question's getting complicated when you have more than two cysteines. And it also requires information when you want to pull this, when you want to start this pulling, because if you have elongated protein which is has linear conformation, you probably do not want to start this process from the beginning, but when they're getting close enough, so it's not good for that purpose. And another one is Schrager's method, is applied for coarse-grained model, so it's not full atom model, and we just skip it. The actual physics of disulfide bond formation, it's kind of dark matter by this day, and you can find in textbooks the states before and after disulfide bond formation, but not what happens in the middle, and the general answer is that actual mechanism depends of your system, and in different environments you have different mechanisms. In most interesting for us solution case, we assume the next mechanism of reaction. We have iron iron cell and another one, and they react and form a disulfide bond and half of water molecule. We simulated this simple reaction with quantum mechanics simulations, and we obtained that profile. Actually, this was done in that paper. And you can see that the reaction, the distance of the reaction is about 2.5 angstrom, and it has a relatively low barrier, and in the water in solution it should be even lower than here. So it's actually, you may think that it's a barrierless reaction. In our model, we actually do not want to simulate two types of residues. These two types of residues, but one. our explanation for that assumption is that the problem we approach is actually a factor, could be factorized in two factors. First is the distance between two sulfur atoms, so they should be close enough to start the reaction. And another one is the chemical state of the residues. And if the probability of ones is seen to have this states equal to the probabilities of another system, we can factor this factor out and simulate just first one related to the distance And we do not want to have multiple different residue types, so we choose the radical one because two pairs of others could not form the bond. Our model system is a guanylyl peptide, which is 15 amino acid in length. It has four cysteines, and these four cysteines may form different bonds, and this linkage difference corresponds to different isomers. The biological the biological active isomer 2 has a really low population in vitro, and that's why in organism in vivo it folds as part of the bigger protein proguanylin, and then cleaved and goes to do its job. So we simulate disulfide bond formation with this part of protein. So the whole protein consists of three parts. Is the relaxation period when we start from random random conformation in explicit solvent, and run conventional MD simulations for 100 nanoseconds to let the protein explore conformational space. After 100 nanoseconds, we start from disulfide bond formation protocol, and our guanylin makes at first one bond, then another one. And after both bonds are formed, we perform one more time, 100 nanosecond period, to let this formed peptide explore conformation space again to perform energy calculation based on that per period. We generate a big ensemble of random structures and put them into the same box of the same size. So all compact and elongated structures has the same freedom. The same freedom. We choose a set of 50. We choose 50 structures from that distribution and start our simulations. By the relaxation period, we obtained averaged radius of duration for 100 nanoseconds, and you can see that it came to the plateau at about 70 nanoseconds. This is this justifies our choice of 100 nanoseconds for relaxation period. Also, we calculated pKa values for that part of the trajectories, and you can see histograms for different cysteines, and you can see that average values do not differ a lot, and our assumption about equivalence of cysteines, at least in MD, is justified also. At log period, we should form the disulfide bond. How we do it? First, we need to encode event of close, of close. So we have to find a frame with close sulfur atoms. as turns out, Amber's force field, 14 SB force field, do not allow two sulfur atoms to come closer than 3 angstroms, which is just wrong, and we just replace interaction between van der Waals interaction between two sulfur atoms with a zero potential, which is in agreement with QM calculations in the vacuum, and the only this is the only part of the trajectory where we actually altering the conventional force field. We tried to once two sulfur atoms came at 2.5 angstroms, we start a log period process, and we tried several profiles for disulfide to introduce disulfide bond, and we end up that when I would choose the green one because it's the most simple and which works and simple. So this didn't work because this steep introduction of force perturbed systems too much, and it was not so good. So after our isomers were formed, we calculate the energies. 45 of 50 trajectories finished as one of the isomer, and the final distribution in the simulation is broadly the same as in the experiment, which this fact makes us sure that kinetic factor which we simulated is dominant in that system. The energy distribution, so the energies for different isomers are not well separated, and this excludes thermal control of isomer distribution. We also simulate progranulin as a whole with the random tails glued to the folded body. Literature suggests that this body folds first and then folds guanylin. Protocol is essentially the same as for guanylin simulations, but with reduced stage time because this system is bigger than previous one, and it takes a longer time to simulate. And one of the our structures match the NMR solid structure. Here you can see that they match very well. If you will compare the RMSD between tails, so the red one, guanylin tail, red now, and if you calculate the RMSD between NMR ensemble and MD structure, you will see that they came close at one point and remain at that value for the whole trajectory, for the rest of the trajectory. Also, we have experimental NOE data for the structure, and we can compare directly our MD frames those values, and our system shows the same value of distance relations as in control. Simulation started exactly from the NMR structure. In conclusion, I want to line up that our method is simple, could fold peptides and proteins, and most of time it's force field is indistinguishable from the original force field. There is a method limitation that cysteines are equivalent, and if I have, do I have time?
No.
Nope. Okay. So I want to thank our laboratory and foundation and you for the attention.
Thank you. Any questions for Sergei?
Do you use for your simulation supercomputing technology?
We used graphical cards to run our MD trajectories. It's basically desktop computers.
How much time do you spend for one trajectory?
Single trajectory is up to 1 micro, and speed on our card is about 100 nanoseconds, so 10 days.
Thank you.
Any more questions? I have a question. I think you, in this work, you describe more or less good situation concerning experimental data. Yes? Is your goal to describe experiment data? Not
so as well as molecular dynamics can, but
my question about the new knowledge from your calculations.
So you use molecular dynamics to somehow justify experiment and vice versa, and this method enables allows you to use it with proteins with disulfide bonds. So,
thank you. Any more questions?
No.
Thank you.
Come on.
Sorry. My question is, if you will use pure Ampere potential force field, do you obtain sulfide bonds or not? Because you told that you modify this potential force field.
With Ampere force field potential, two sulfur atoms could not get closer than, we didn't observe them, they get closer than 3 angstroms, which is more than reaction coordinates that we think.
And consequence questions. Does it mean that all other simulations of proteins which can form disulfide bonds are wrong with standard potential force field?
I think basically yes.
Thank you.
So I should finish questions. Thank you very much.